About 10 miles off San Carlos, on the east coast of Mexico. We happen to be my old friend, Dr. Graham, director of the Miami Marine Institute, and myself, Mike Nelson. Dr. Graham had sold me on exploring an underwater cave. He had pretty solid evidence that it contained some fossils more than 80 million years old. If true, this could be one of the most important scientific finds in years, or it could be a washout. It was my job to prove it, one way or the other. Dr. Graham first learned about the cave when he received a package of underwater photos from someone in San Carlos. They showed the entrance to the cave and a fossil that had been found just beyond it. The photos had been taken by an American artist named Carter, who said that currents made the cave inaccessible. There was just no way of getting into it. Well, Carter had to be wrong. There didn't seem to be any currents down here to speak of. Upstairs, Dr. Graham could see me on the closed circuit TV setup. He'd been quite worried about Carter's warning. Suddenly, I gave him and myself something to worry about for real. A maze of currents seemingly from out of nowhere hit me like pile drivers. It was the strangest turbulence I'd ever been in. Through that vortex and into the cave would take all the strength and skill I had, plus a lot of luck. It turned out that a lot of it was bad luck. My next pass at the cave, I tried something new. I released some dye, hoping it might show me some kind of a clear channel through the turbulence. No matter from what point I tried it, my experiment just proved that there was no way of outguessing these peculiar currents. No way of predicting them either. To make my way any distance into the cave, I was going to need extra help.
You all right, Mike?
Oh, sure. Well, I found the cave. We're halfway home.
In 53 hours, we'll be all the way home, to the States, that is. That picture was very clear. That turbulence was positively frightening.
Oh, you know how TV exaggerates everything.
Yes, but I don't like violence. I'm prepared to risk anything for those fossils. But, Mike, your life is not one of them.
Well, I think I could have made it if I had enough power.
What?
Special equipment. Sea scooter.
I may be as dense as my fossils, but, Mike, why is this challenge so irresistible to you?
Well, you want those fossils, don't you?
Of course I do, but...
Well?
What do you have in mind?
A fast trip to San Carlos. See if we can find that guy that took those photos that you showed me, huh? Apparently he's a diver. Maybe he's got a scooter. If he hasn't, maybe he can help me find somebody who has.
Yes, but San Carlos isn't on our way home.
Oh? But it might be an interesting detour.
we got to San Carlos, Dr. Graham went ashore for provisions. I put away my gear. I wouldn't need it till I located a scooter. I wasn't doing anything very unusual, but it sure interested my audience.
Your boat?
Uh-huh.
It is a very beautiful boat.
Oh, thanks. I think so, too.
You take very good care of it, sir.
Well, she's the only one I got.
Oh. Then you should not leave it unguarded.
Oh, I shouldn't, huh? What? Is this a tough neighborhood?
Si, senor. There's a very dangerous gang who play on the wharf.
Well, I have to go into the village. What do you suggest I do?
In my opinion, you should hire me to guard your boat for the small sum of 25 cents American.
Oh, you think that'd be a good idea, huh? Are you sure there's such a gang?
Very sure. I am their leader.
Oh, well, in that case, it's a pleasure to do business with such an upstanding young man. Hey, my friend, you watch that boat, huh? Oh. Now that you're working for me, maybe you can help me find an American by the name of Carter, huh?
The famous artist?
That's the one.
Si, senor. The American artist is the biggest attraction on my guided tour.
Guided tour, huh? Well, how much is that going to cost me?
You are very lucky, senor. It is the off-season, and I will give you the tour for the small sum of 25 cents, American.
Who's going to be watching my boat?
It will be safe, senor. The dangerous gang is taking a siesta.
There you are. Catch it.
This is the studio of our biggest attraction.
Hey, we can't just barge in like this. Nobody's home.
That is all right, senor. The American artist says I can come in anytime.
You sure?
Si, senor.
Look at that. How's that?
Uh-uh. If that's a criticism, you can keep it to yourself. Once more.
And this is our biggest attraction in person.
Every town should have one.
Si, senor.
Thanks, huh? Come on. Back to your job, Don Juan.
Job?
Hey, you're watching my boat.
Let's see.
Oh, you see, it looks good from any angle.
It stinks from any angle.
What is it, anyway?
It's an underwater cave.
Oh, this is a cave that you wrote to us about, huh? I'm working with Dr. Graham. My name's Mike Nelson.
I'm Cheryl Carter. Yes, this is the same cave.
You know, I didn't expect you to be a woman.
Sorry.
Oh, don't be. I wouldn't change a thing. Oh, this sure doesn't look like the cave that I saw. Of course, I was being knocked around a little bit at the time.
You didn't take my letter seriously, huh? I told you the cave was inaccessible.
I don't know. I was hoping that I'd prove you wrong.
And you didn't.
No, that's why I'm here. I need a scooter. Do you have one by any chance?
You haven't signed a suicide pact by any chance.
Nah, it's not that dangerous.
It is, too. I was darn near killed down there.
Well, I'd still like to try it. Do you have a scooter?
You know something? I wish I did. There isn't any equipment like that nearer than Key West. I don't suppose that would stop you, though, would it?
You always this helpful, or is today an exception, huh?
Just that I don't like to see a person commit suicide. That's all.
Oh, neither do I. Thanks anyway, huh?
Please let me know if you locate a scooter. I'd like to be around if you try the cave again.
Oh, yeah? Why?
I'm a whiz with a first aid kit.
Hi, Don Juan.
Hi, Senor Mike. Were you successful with the senorita?
Is anybody?
You talked to her about the cave, no?
Hey, how'd you know about that?
One cannot be a good guide without knowing many things. Is it important that you get into the cave?
Yeah, very important.
There's something I should tell you.
As soon as I make this radio call, I'll be right with you.
I put in a call to Key West, to an underwater supply outfit that I'd done business with before. When I outlined my problem to them, they agreed to ship a scooter down to me, the most powerful one available. If I were right, it'd get me through the turbulence. And if Cheryl Carter were right, it'd pile me up on the rocks.
All right, over and out. You went a lot of effort for this old bottle.
See, Senor Mike, for this bottle I did. As you can see, it is empty.
Yeah, sure it is. You expect something to be inside of it?
Tell me, Senor, what does a sailor do when he's shipwrecked on a lonely little island?
Oh, I don't know. I suppose he hopes another ship will come by, doesn't he?
See, he does that sometimes. But other times, he finds a piece of paper. Then he searches for a bottle that has been washed ashore by the tide. And you know what he does then?
Well, sure, he writes a message.
But how? He has no pencil, and nothing grows on the island.
Hey, that poses a problem, doesn't it, huh?
It does, until he finds a pen.
Fountain pen, huh?
No, a pen.
That's what I said, a pen.
A pen, you know, like, ouch.
Oh, pen.
And after he's found this pin, he writes a secret message. In blood, Senor. His own blood.
Oh, boy. Hey, that's real clever of him.
Then he puts the message in the bottle and throws it far beyond the waves, where the tide will carry it all over the world.
Yeah, well, I bet you've received a lot of those secret messages, huh?
I received none, Senor Mike.
Oh, you haven't?
No, but this is a very favorable time of year for secret messages.
I sure hope you get one real soon.
When mine comes, I will share it with you, Senor. Until then, I get 2 cents a bottle all year round.
What are you going to do with all that money you get?
I'm saving to buy a pair of fins. 6 more cases of empty bottles, and I'll have enough.
Come with me, huh? I think these pair might fit you.
For me?
For you. Come on, boy. Hey, you were going to tell me something about that cave. Huh?
Senorita Carter says no one can get inside. And she is never wrong, she says.
Yeah? Well, we'll show her a thing or two, won't we?
Scooter arrived at the dock early the next morning. So did Cheryl Carter with her first aid kit. Don Juan, meantime, was in conference with his gang. What a character.
Why did you not tell Senor Mike about the other way into the cave?
Because he's here only for this job. And when it is over, we'll go home.
You did wrong, Don Juan. That's a very bad cave.
I want my amigo to stay in San Carlos.
See, he will stay in San Carlos. In the graveyard, maybe.
Senor,
I'd used a lot of scooters, but this model seemed to deliver more power than most. All the same, it didn't have power enough to pull me in a straight course and into the cave. The currents at the entrance bucked me around like a bronco. If I moved at all, it was sideways.
Stay with it, Mike.
Go, man, go.
I had all I could do just to hold on to the scooter. That turned out to be a mistake. The current slammed the scooter back into my face. It cracked me so hard it just about knocked me out. I was like a fighter down for the count. I didn't know where I was or what was happening. I grabbed at the first object that I came into contact with. It turned out to be a rock. I couldn't seem to get organized. I couldn't see much either. The scooter had cracked my faceplate as well as my head.
Gonzalez hasn't finished examining him yet.
He's going to be all right.
Good.
Are you sure, Senorita?
He's lucky he wasn't killed.
San Carlos for a few days longer than I expected.
I'm sorry, Senor. It was my fault. I should have told you of the cave.
You're the only one who didn't.
I should have told you of the other way inside.
Other way? I must still be a little groggy. What do you mean, other way?
Si, Senor. It is true. There's another way into the cave.
For gosh sakes, why didn't you tell me this before?
I wanted you to stay in San Carlos forever.
I almost did.
I made you a map. I know what I did was wrong. It was selfish.
Well, this is a way into that cave from the land.
See. Please don't hate me, amigo.
Dr. Graham, come in here, quick.
What is it, Mike? What's the matter?
Take a look at that. It's another way into the cave. Into those fossils you've been looking for.
Why, this is a land-based entrance.
That's right.
No turbulence to worry about that way.
Don't sound so disappointed.
This is wonderful.
Yeah, we got Don Juan to thank for it. Where'd he go? Take a look, huh?
He's gone.
It was another few days before I was ready to work again. But Don Juan's map made it easy to get started. The land-based entrance to the cave was shaped something like a crater. Actually, it was a blowhole through the coral into the sea. I rigged a lifeline to make sure that I'd be able to get out as easily as I got in. It didn't take long to find the fossil bed for Dr. Graham. Digging out the fossils, though, would take time. And it could be dangerous. When you do any excavation work underwater, you risk starting a chain reaction. the whole war could come down on me. I'd have to be mighty careful. I got the message. I'd have to be a lot more careful. Dr. Graham's enthusiasm spurred me on. I managed to clean out the major part of the fossil bed within 2 weeks. This last chunk of rock looked especially promising to me. But you need an expert eye, like Dr. Graham's, to know for sure. A week more and the job was done. All that remained was to say goodbye to the natives.
Hi, Mike. Got something for you.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Oh. Oh, something new has been added. What's this?
That's you.
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Gerald, friend of friend, don't you think you ought to give up painting and stick to diving?
I don't know why I like you so much.
You do?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so now you tell me, huh, when I'm ready to go home.
I've been trying to tell you all along, but you were too interested in fossils.
Well, next time it won't be fossils.
There he is now, Mike. There's Don Juan.
Yeah, hold it, will you? Be right back. Hey, Don Juan, I've been looking all over for you. Where you been keeping yourself?
Please forgive me, Senor Mike. Please forgive me.
For what? Well, if it hadn't been for you, I never would have found those fossils. And that map you made. Boy, that was a great job.
You really mean it, Senor?
Of course I mean it.
Then we're still amigos?
You bet we're still amigos. Come on, let's go. Sure tough to leave these wonderful people, huh, Dr. Graham?
Sure is.
Thanks a lot for this. We'll find a special place for it aboard, huh?
Sure.
Good luck, Mike.
Goodbye, Senor Mike.
Goodbye, Don Juan.
If you come back to San Carlos, I will guard your boat for free.
And you can finish that guided tour, too, huh? We'll take Cheryl along with us. You look after our biggest attraction, huh?
See.
Mike, young Don Juan.
Hey, take the wheel a minute, huh? You got a pin?
A what?
You know, like ouch.
Like what?
I guess it was a silly idea. Here. Take your pin.
Don Juan wouldn't mind too much that his first secret message turned out to be written in ink. I plan to go back to San Carlos someday and find out.
I'll be back next week at the same time with another Sea Hunt story. Plan to be with us again, huh?